So what is medical laboratory science? Some would call it medical technology, some would call it clinical laboratory science. So the persons engaged here normally are called scientists, medical laboratory scientists, medical technologists, clinical laboratory scientists. Okay, so we are more into diagnosis, helping the medical doctors as well as other health professionals who are in need of the services of the laboratory, the clinical laboratory. So, okay. Sharing with us the vision mission of the university, we already know that the medical laboratory science graduates are actually lifelong learners. This is the vision of the university, working with one mind, one heart to search for, discover, and share truth for the promotion of authentic human and societal development. It aims to form the members of its academic community in members rather in virtus et scientia, Western Visayas, the Philippines, and the world. And of course, we are expecting the graduates of this esteemed institution that they will become a transformative community builder, restless, critical, and creative thinker, as well as social communicator of the truth. Okay, so of course, the quality objective of the MLS program is to provide quality Augustinian education through integral formation, instruction, research, and innovation, and community extension programs by efficient and effective implementation and also continually improving processes to meet client satisfaction. So, the medical laboratory science program is actually a 4 years program. It's not a 3 years, not even a 5 years, but rather a 4 years program. So in the first 3 years, we have the first year to third year. All courses offered here are general education and professional courses. And the fourth year, this is the terminal year. No, this is what we call the internship year. So it's a 1 year internship. Everything that you have learned from first year to third year, you're now going to apply it here in the internship. Okay? So in the first year, the professional courses included here would include our introduction to the medical laboratory science. So when did medical laboratory science started as a discipline? Particularly here at the university, we started way back 1962. Then we have courses including anatomy and physiology. Then we have community public health. Then we have phlebotomy, as well as clinical laboratory practices. In the second year, the professional core courses would include cytogenetics, principles and strategies teaching medical laboratory science. Then we have biostatistics and epidemiology. Then we have medical biochemistry, laboratory management, as well as medtech laws, ethics, and of course, not to forget, histology and parasitology. This is in preparation for the third year professional courses, like your clinical chemistry, your hematology, your bacteriology, histopathology, thesis writing. Then we have mycology and virology, immunology and serology, blood banking or immunohematology, and of course, the last but not the least, molecular biology. For the MLS fourth year internship, we have 7 affiliated training laboratories, aside of course from the main laboratory that we have here at the university. So of course, not to forget, we have our very own tertiary training laboratory, the USA Clinical Laboratory, which is located here at the Urdaneta, now the oldest building here in the university. Then we have the WVMC Hospital Lab. That's actually our base hospital right now. We have the St. Paul's Hospital Laboratory, Iloilo Doctors Hospital Lab, Iloilo Mission Hospital Lab, Medicus Medical Center Lab, QualiMed Lab, as well as the Philippine National Red Cross Blood Bank Lab. But I'm also proud to say that sooner or later, that the Asia-Pacific Medical Center would be opening its doors. And that would be our base hospital now in the coming years. So it's a very big hospital. The university has inked an agreement with them. So all four programs, all health allied programs, the base hospital now would be the APMC. So hopefully you guys, no, once you decided to be a part of the CHOMP, no, you would experience your internship in the APMC. Aside, of course, from the already mentioned affiliated training laboratories. As of the moment, the internship is on a limited face-to-face because of the reasons, no? We are still in the pandemic era and we don't have limited face-to-face classes in the lower years. But we are actually utilizing other forms of hybrid learning like your NEO LMS using the learning management system that is being offered right now, the NEO LMS. Okay? So, what are those areas of practices when you become a medical laboratory science? When you earn the degree, of course, you have to earn the license. So what are those? You can go into the academe, now research and the academe. And you could be a product specialist. Remember, it's not simply working in the lab. You could also be a product specialist. What are those? Those which are actually promoting, no? And at the same time, working to come up with diagnostic materials using machine. So these are what we call product specialists. You would be employed, no, in a manufacturing firm, several companies. To mention, we have Siemens, we have Merck, and all the others. No, these are international companies that they have their local distributors here. In Iloilo and the Southeast, we have Singapore. So if you would want to become an employee there, you could be a product specialist. What else? You could also be employed as a forensic criminologist. No? Forensic med tech as a criminologist. Working in a crime lab. No? Working at the PNP, Philippine National Police. Of course, the armed forces and even those auxiliary and branch, no, forces that is dealing with criminal diagnosis or criminal trying to solve those criminal cases. So you could be employed there. So we have several alumni, no? We have several both from the undergrad as well as in the graduate programs are now working as a forensic med tech as well as criminologist. What else? Of course, primarily, the main bulk of the work, the main bulk of graduates end up working as a med tech in hospital laboratories as well as in the industries. This is where the clinical laboratory scientists, no, ending up as a microbiologist, as a drug analyst, as a clinical chemistry analyst, as hematologist, and so on and so forth. Okay? So you could work in the local arena, you could work in the regional level, or even international. We have lots of graduates who are working right now abroad. We have notable alumni working in the John Hopkins Hospital in Maryland. Now we have even working in other renowned hospital laboratories, no, outside the Philippines. So when did the medical laboratory science started? This started way back in 1962. Okay? So remember that the University of San Agustin is the only university, no, of the Augustinian order in the Asia-Pacific region. Take note of that. And the University of San Agustin is the first university is the Western, now in the Western Visayas region. The medical laboratory science program as of the moment is level 2 PASCO accredited, and we are working forward, no, moving on so that hopefully in the coming years we would be accredited, no, in another level, as well as not only in PASCO, we're trying to work, no, with other accreditation institution. Of course, we have to subject ourselves in order for us to maintain quality and excellence. So the different facilities that you would be encountering with if you would decide to be with the medical laboratory science program would be the research laboratories, no? So these are located at the Mendel Hall, the ORGR. Some of you would be acquainted with that, no? At the C2B2, CND3, and even we have our very own undergraduate research laboratory at the Mendel Hall, no? The Gregor Mendel Research Laboratory. And we have instructional laboratories. As of the moment, you can see here picture the instructional lab located at the second as well as in the fourth floor and even the third floor of Mendel. These instructional laboratories would include anatomy and physiology lab. We have the chemistry laboratories. But of course, we have professional instructional laboratories located at the fourth floor. As of the moment, pictures not included here, the newly constructed medtech laboratory at the fifth floor. Okay, just right at the other side of the area would be your pharmacy laboratory. The one that was shown by Ma'am Villanueva a while ago. So if we have the manufacturing lab at the other side, that would be the left wing, and the right wing would be the additional instructional laboratories for the medical laboratory science. Then we have, of course, the training laboratories and hospital affiliations, no? So the one that you can see here in the picture right now is the clinical lab. This is the receiving area. So as of the moment, we are actually upgrading our facilities. Remember, upgrading of facilities is not only one time, but every once in a while, because we would want to keep up with the standards, no? By regulating bodies, no? That would include the DOH, the CHED, and other accrediting bodies. So we have to keep up with the said standards. So equipments that you could actually encounter, no? In the laboratory would be, like, example here would be analyzers. This one on the picture is actually the hematology analyzers. Then we have, of course, for electrolytes determination in the clinical chemistry. These are just samples. Then we have, of course, machines that looks like the robot in the Star Wars. We have here the autoclave machines. No, this is for sterilization. So we have here at the clinical microbiology sections. There's lots of laboratory equipments here in the clinical lab, but you would also encounter in the affiliated training hospitals. So modern ones, those which are still being used 10 years ago, but still, shall we say, functional. But of course, you see when in the hospital laboratory, you have to keep up with the standards. So normally the equipment are actually upgraded usually every 2 to 5 years. So depending on the needs, no, the turnaround time that it would be serving and so on and so forth. Of course, no. So talking about the achievements of the medical laboratory science, remember that we are still included in the top performing school. So the one that I am showing to you right now, the latest data that I can show you is as of September 2019, because September 2020 we don't have any examinees for the licensure examination. And we have only a handful of examinees that took the board exam last 2021. So hopefully this 2022, we would have, no, takers now. Because in the PRC, to be counted, you have to have more than 50 examinees. So last September 2019, we garnered a 91.40% for the passing percentage versus the 73%, no, for the national passing. We are always way behind, or rather way, no, the national passing is way behind the USA passing. We are always above the national passing. So I can, as you can see here in the table, no, in this figure shown here from September 2019 to March of 2014. So that's a span of what, 5 years. But way back, even before, during the time of the 1960s to 1970s, for almost 6 decades already, because 1962, so 60 years ng medical laboratory science, we are always in the top performing category. Okay? If not in the top 5, we are always in the top 10. Of course, in the last in 2018 as well as 2017, we garnered the top spot, no? The top performing school, number one. Okay? And talking about board top notchers, as of this date, we have already produced 89 board top notchers. 72 were within the top 10 spot. 17 were within the 11th to 20th spot. Okay? So, with that, I would like to thank you for listening. You know, the very short presentation of the Medical Laboratory Science Program. But before we end, let me share with you a short video presentation which were made by the Medical Laboratory Science interns.